Warning, adventure activities can be extremely dangerous. Please use extreme caution when out in the elements, and if you should, go ask your mom. Now, go ahead and in.
Yes, we're going to follow all of it. We're going to look at every one of these legends, and we're going to track it down to see what we can find. And we're dealing with people that were used to traveling thousands of miles in the worst conditions. So it wouldn't have been a big deal for them if they had decided that we're going to stash something up in the top of those mountains. And they were down here. It wouldn't have been that big a deal. That's what they did. So it's not like they would have it in the easier places like maybe I would, right? I try to find a place close to wherever I found it. Let's say it's the massacre site. They didn't feel that way. You know, the natives would go 70 miles a day. The Spanish, actually, I mean, other than the fact that they carried large groups of people with them, a lot of stock, would travel slower, but they didn't have a problem going wherever they needed to go. It wasn't that big a deal to them. So that's, you can't just dissect or deduct that they're going to be close, right? So you've got to look everywhere. It could be down here. It'd be fun if we stumbled into it today. We take the money, put it all on black.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
Because it's gambling, right? That's what we're doing today. This is... Vegas South.
So here we are, and you know, we made it through our first, you know, initial trail with the, you know, full intentions of following a line on that needle.
Now, so if you don't understand, one thing that people don't realize is the how big this is, and the fact that when we do a 360 degree, that could take 3 years easily. Look at there. Look at that jack. That's a big rabbit.
That's a good-sized rabbit.
So hopefully we'll see the coyote behind him. But the acreage here is unbelievable. I mean, you're going to hike and hike and hike. And it's going to be a difficult journey. But you know what? That's what we're up for. So, I mean, while we're going to go through the legends, we're going to go through the different maps, we're going to go through all the history, we're going to talk about everybody that spent time here, that lived their lives here. People spent their life here looking for this treasure. And, you know, we have a little better technology than they had at the time. But you know what the reality of it is? There's a point where you can Google Maps all you want, but then it's like James liked to say, what do you like to say, James? You like to say, boots on the ground.
Oh, boots, that's exactly what I like. I say I hike it.
Because you got to hike it. I mean, you can look all you want. And I'm going to tell you that you ain't going to see it on Google Maps. I hate to tell you this. So if you're thinking you're going to find this on Google Maps, I shouldn't say you're not. But if you are, then go hike it and go see if it's there. Now, what we're going to do in this episode is we're going to take from this parking lot here and work our way back to where we started the other day to try to see still if there's any indicators of any markings on cactus, things like that. But we've still got to go around there. Do I think anything's over there? No, but you know, you just don't know. So you don't know what to expect. You don't know. So you just have to physically put the boots on the ground and look for those markers that might tell you there's something over here. Because if it's a cache, it could be anywhere. You know, it could be anywhere. So I think, James, what we'll do is let's get to the highest point.
Yep.
And then take a look around 360.
Yep.
So we'll head up this peak right up here and see if we see any indications at all.
Yep. Eyes peeled for any blazes, any manipulated cactus, any rocks, stuff like that, right?
Absolutely.
That's the plan, okay. We're like officially Dutch hunting.
Yes. We are officially Dutch hunting.
Well, I'm not going to argue with that view over there in the canyon. Pretty nice, man.
That's look at that canyon. People don't realize that's what you get out here. You know, one thing that I want people to notice is that there's barbed wire fence out here. So they used to run cattle out here. So think about the fact that also in this area, you had a ton of cowboys coming through here. So a lot of people saw a lot of this area while they were herding cattle and things like that. But you never know though, you still gotta look. But you know, there were cowboys roaming this area regularly in this vicinity. So I feel pretty comfortable that maybe somebody would have found it if it had been over here, but you still gotta look. Look at that beauty over there. That's one thing you're gonna see about the beauty of the Superstitions is, this place is spectacular. Looks like a nice trail there, James. We can go to that next point.
Exactly.
You know, I was thinking about the Dutchman. And the thing that I want to think about is that this guy had gold fever. And also, this is a guy that made his living making big rocks, little rocks. Can you imagine what kind of physical shape he would be in, you know, to be able to do that and to be a miner back then? And that, you know, what we think of normal, you know, difficulties wouldn't have been shit for him. I mean, look at this terrain. It wouldn't even have bothered him. Now remember also, he had to take a mule 60 miles to get here. So you want to talk about a time commitment to come into these Superstition Mountains. You know, I'm kind of overwhelmed just thinking about the effort that it would have taken him. Now, here's another thing too. Whether you believe the gold or not, he was in this area and they saw him. So he was here. Whether he was prospecting or whatever he was doing. So he spent time here. Now that we know for sure. So we had the Dutchman and we have him in the location. Why would he be down here if there wasn't something down here, you know? And this guy mined gold from the East Coast to the West Coast, up to Vulture. So he wasn't a guy that didn't understand what gold looked like and what the rock structure looked like. So he wouldn't have been just been jacking around here. Those guys knew what kind of areas and the geology to know that there was gold or there wasn't gold. You know, James saw these white poles out here, and we don't know if it's Tonto or maybe the Lost Dutchman Park, or, you know, who knows what indicators this could possibly be, but they're all the way across. So somebody spent the time and the energy, and James got him a chola. You don't get too many cholas. What's up with that?
That guy just hopped at a... Oh, it was off that little guy. Well,
how are you going to get him off? What's your system?
I'm going to do a little of this. And they always go right deep like that, too. It's so fun.
Let's take a look at that, because this is one of 1,000.
That was pretty painless.
I heard guys say that they used... Combs, James.
Combs is the best from what everyone says because it like kind of catches in there and it keeps it from jumping back onto you.
Yeah, because that's what happened to me every time. I pull them or try to pop them off and they jump back.
Yeah, deeper. I can actually... I just never carry a comb, obviously, if you look at my head.
I wouldn't have known that, James.
Not my thing, but for that purpose, it might be worth getting a 99 cent plastic comb.
They're not.
The marker we were looking at. Could be any number of things, I suppose.
What's the tag say on it?
Molly Marie number 11 southeast. Molly Marie number 15 southwest. I have no idea what that is.
Well, there's another one there.
There is one up there.
They're plastic.
There's one over there.
You know, they have a stack of surveyors. That's the rock stack of surveyors that I see throughout. But there's one over there too, which is kind of funny. Why would that be there and there?
If they have the same name on them, that would tell me that's the title of some kind of claim or something, right?
Well, you know,
not necessarily a claim, but like a claim to the land itself. Or if it's some like scientific research.
You know, this is funny, James, because this is funny. Why would you call it Molly Marie if it wasn't some type of mine, right?
Exactly. It sounds to me like the name of a boat or a mine.
I mean, I see the coordinates, which I get if it was, but why would you name it?
I don't know.
Well,
like I said, I'm going to go look at the other one now.
We're going to now have to go and see if it's got the same name or a different name.
And once we're in a place I have service, we're going to look that up. Explain it next time.
Why would that, you know, just again, it wouldn't have said that name. I would have thought, you know, this is some type of boundary, right?
Well,
but why would it?
I really believe that's what it was.
But why would it be that name?
I'll have to look it up, dude.
Now,
it could definitely be for research of some sort,
or it could have been the surveyor that,
or something of that nature. I mean, that's the name of something, it sounds like. Whether it's the initials or MM is more relevant than Molly Marie, who knows? Let's go look it up though.
I'm going to take this little creek bed up, I think. Anytime I can steal a fake trail, I'm going to do it. Again, though, another thing, James, is here's a whole nother set of people that were out here.
Absolutely. Absolutely. There's no shortage of people in the superstitions in today's world, that's for sure. I guess never, really. There's always been people up here. If you get into it. See. Here we are to the next marker we saw. This one looks like it's older. Molly Marie, number 15, south end. Okay, so it's property or something, right?
Well, you know, I'm not sure. And you know, we don't claim to know all this stuff. So if anybody knows exactly what that is.
Yeah, I'm gonna research it and we'll put it in the next one. But until then, if you know, let us know, because that'd be cool for us to figure out what we're looking at here.
Because, you know, there's all kinds of markers in different locations all over the state. But it's kind of funny that, you know, I'd say it's still some type of land. But again, who knows? Who knows?
We'll see.
You know, one of the things that really has been interesting to me is the amount of people that's decided that this is their graveyard. You just stumble into graves all over out here. And I find that unique that people have decided that they love the Superstition Mountains so much. And I get it, but it's just funny. You didn't see that before. Now I was
sneak my body out here one of these days, man.
Oh, I'll dust you out. Hopefully you'll have found gold though before we send you on your journey.
But yeah, no, this could definitely be a good resting place.
Hey James, I think I found somebody that was here at the same time that the Lost Dutchman was here.
Who?
Cactus Jack. Look at that thing.
That is a big
man. And you know, he lost one of his arms, and you know, who knows? maybe that was one of the indicators, you know, that maybe,
because
that thing had been here for a long time. Man, it just overwhelms me sometimes how much space and how much beauty's up here. And we haven't even dipped our toe in the pool.
No, we just started. No shortage of just weird stuff out here. But essentially the middle of the random trail is some fashion rock.
Well, I'm finding the horse tracks through here. So somebody's actually, a lot of people do go riding out here.
Well, it definitely seems that way.
Broken glass.
Yeah, I saw a bunch of shells back there, too.
Okay, there's a man-made structure. Okay, that's weird.
Oh,
okay, what?
What's that about?
Was this just a draw for some type of cattle?
Probably
look at that, though.
From destroying the trail down below.
Man, that's an old wall. That's an old cowboy wall, right? Or a miner wall. That's a miner wall.
Yeah.
I mean, I saw enough of them yesterday in the old mine up there. The Richenbar mine, they were exactly like these.
Yeah. It's old concrete, you're right.
Somebody had to haul concrete out here.
Yeah.
I mean, they
dragged a Corona out here.
Boy, I would think there'd be a lot more funner places to go than here, drinking a Corona and having to build this dam. This reminds me of a miner's dam, though. It doesn't remind me of a... I'm telling you, this definitely... Now, the only thing I will say is this. That's the style of a miner, but most miners, believe it or not, would have had a nicer finish. They kind of appreciated the structure of building stuff, where they're gobbing the mines or whatever. You usually see really a nice gobbing because it's gonna, it potentially could save their lives. But it is worth it to take a look around here knowing that you've been in the middle of some stuff. You know, that little ledge up there doesn't look completely natural. But again, like we were talking, they were searching for this gold all over this area. You know, one of the things that you're looking for out here is dumps. You know, where these guys used to spend time out here, there's encampments, and you know, they had trash and garbage. They hauled in all their stuff on mules, and the reality of it is they weren't as conscious about hauling it out. They weren't hauling trash out of here. They were throwing it. So one of the ways that we can also, James saw some old bottles, but you know, who knows where that came from, but there would be dumps out here if they were spending time in one area. So that's one of the things we're definitely looking for, is old dumps where they had, you know, they had encampments. So that's something else we're looking for when we come out here. But boy, there used to be people all over here, especially closer to the road where they could get in here searching for it. So it's not that unique, but...
But definitely one of the many signs we're looking for.
Absolutely.
Plus, you find a lot of cool stuff in dumps.
Well, maybe our goal will be bottles. Maybe we'll find some old whiskey bottles, James.
That might be a more realistic treasure.
I want gold.
I know you do.
I want that shiny.
You know,
it's not unique in the superstitions, believe it or not, to see helicopters, because I won't say they haul them out here daily, but they haul them out of here. You know, James, I saw some unique people out here already.
You did?
I saw a guy with a mullet.
Yeah, we did.
So you never know what you're going to find out in the Superstition Mountains. Just when you thought. And he probably's been out here since 1973. And he ain't found the gold yet.
Hey, mullet man, say hi if you're watching.
Mullet man, if you saw us, you know, all the thing I say to you is, send it!